Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. From this video onwards, we'll be focusing on using the 3D shape to solve a variety of compositing tasks. As I mentioned in my previous videos, the best way to think about this is that you are using 3D technology to solve a series of 2D compositing challenges. The first scenario deals with object removal and image cleanup. If you want to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. So here we have a shot of our talent, and we have been asked to remove the logo from his clothing. You could use traditional techniques such as painting or masking. However, the 3D shape gives you a unique and flexible alternative for this sort of work. We'll start off in Batch, where I have an image connected into the action background input. I already have the same media connected to the first media input node. If you connected the blue matte input, then you will need to turn the matte off in the media list. Or, only connect the red front input, and you won't need to change any other settings. Double-click on the action node for its controls. Ensure you have the action schematic in the left view, and the result in the right view. Since we will use media projecting onto a 3D shape, you do not need this surface and its axis. Just delete them to give us a clean start. So the area we're going to concentrate on is removing the logo on the right side of the talent's top. Zoom the view to 200% and use spacebar to pan the image over to see the logo. Go to the Action Bin menu and double-click on the 3D Shape node to add it to the composite. Now just start drawing a spline using a few vertices across the logo. Just make sure that the end vertex points go beyond the logo to give more coverage when the logo is removed. Click Finish to complete the open spline. Now let's generate the 3D shape from the spline. Click the Tools pull-down menu and choose Add Points or press the A hotkey. Next, hold Shift and drag outwards from the spline to set the thickness of the 3D shape. It needs to be slightly bigger than the actual logo. Remember to press M to switch back to select mode. So here we have a flat 3D shape with hard edges. To soften the edges, double-click on the 3D shape node. Change the GMOSC transparency setting to for 3D shape only. So the open spline is being feathered, but now we can see the logo through the softness. To fix this, go to the GMOSC tab and select the gradient menu. Grab the middle control point in the graph and drag it upwards. This will adjust the softness between the spline and the edge of the gradient. Tweak it until you can't see the logo. Now let's project the media onto this 3D shape. Double-click on the 3D shape node. Press the media projection button to project the media onto the 3D shape. Since the media is projected through the camera, it will instantly line up. At this point, you have two choices. You can obscure the logo or remove it completely. To obscure the logo, double-click on the projection node in the action schematic. In the projection controls, ensure Regen is enabled for interactivity. You can adjust the effects slider to completely blacken or whiten the area of the 3D shape. Or, you can adjust the softness to blur the texture on the 3D shape. So for hiding or blurring anything, these options are quick and easy. But let's look at how to completely remove the logo. I'll set all these controls back to their default values. Instead of blurring or darkening the projection, you can shift the projected media to remove the logo. Double-click on the axis node above the projection node. Move the projection down and to the right using the transformation controls. Just use the crease of the clothing to line up the projection. If you press I to hide the icons, you can see that the logo is gone from this frame. Now this will work for one frame. However, if you scrub the time bar, you will see that we need to track the 3D shape to the logo. Bring back your icons with I and select the GMask node to bring up the open spline. Hold Ctrl and drag a box selection around all the vertices of the spline. In the GMask tab, switch to the tracking menu. The tracker is set to track each vertex. Click the tracker button. So each vertex has been converted into a set of tracker boxes. Because the end vertices of the spline go further than the logo, let's offset the tracker to ensure they are tracked correctly. Change the tool's pull-down menu from Select to Offset Reference. Hold Ctrl and drag the tracker 1 to the first letter of the logo. Switch to tracker 4 and offset the tracker to the end of the logo. I'll ensure I'm on frame 1 and press the Analyze button. Once the analysis has been completed, press the Return button to exit the stabilizer. So if I scrub the time bar, we can see that the spline is locked to the movement of the talent. Turn the icons off and use the Zoom menu to fit the image to the view. So by using 3D shapes with projections, you have seen how quick and easy it is to cover something or clean up an image. I'll just switch back to Batch and go to this action node. Here I have the same shot where I've done a bit more work. The logo and zip have been removed from the clothing using open and closed 3D shapes. And to finish this off, his eyes have been blurred to mask his identity using the same technique with the 3D shape. There will be more videos on using the 3D shape as a compositing tool very soon. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos. We'll be right back.